इंट्रोडक्शन टू फिजिक्स एंड बायोलॉजी, राइट? सो विल स्टार्ट विद बायोलॉजी फर्स्ट. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय बायोलॉजी?
Is biology like something to do with like how it works? Like how something works, like if something like animals and stuff.
Okay,
So
biology is basically that part of science that study about the life and the living organisms. Okay? These living organisms includes the human beings, the animals, everyone, even the plants. So plants, human beings, animals, all are included in the biology. Now, what basically in biology we study? We study about their physical structures, the chemical processes going inside their bodies, or their development, their evolution, everything we studied in biology. In sixth standard, what basically we study in biology is first we study about food. What kind of foods are there? There are different types of foods. The main categories are vegetarian and non-vegetarian, right? You know about no vegetarian and non-vegetarian? Okay. So food, different kinds of foods are there. We talk about the rice, the wheat, the barley, the pulses. All that comes under the category of food. The eggs, the chicken, mutton, everything is food. So first we will study something about food. What types of varieties of foods are there? What comes under vegetarian? What comes under non-vegetarian foods? Now, this vegetarian, non-vegetarian, these are the categories for animals as well as for human beings, right? Animals are also categorized under vegetarian and non-vegetarian. That animals which are completely vegetarian are known to be herbivores. You have known to this term herbivores, and what are the animals which are completely non-vegetarian? What we call them?
Carnivores.
Yeah, the complete non-vegetarian animals we call carnivores. And what are omnivores?
Omnivores are they eat non-vegetarian and vegetarian both. Like they
Yes,
eat both.
omnivores are those which eat veg as well as non-veg. So human beings come under the category of omnivores. These three categories are for complete living organisms. Okay? Live in living organism, they now we categorize the human beings and the animals separately. So all three, these three categories are for living organisms, right? You there? Okay. I'm not explaining you any topic in detail. I'm just giving you an overview of biology, and then we'll give an overview of physics, okay? When we will take up these topics one by one, I will give you a complete explanations of this topic. After the food, we are going to study about the food chain. Food chain is basically what? How plants, animals, or instead of animals, I will say living organisms, because living organism will constitute both the animals and the human being. So how plants and living organisms are related to each other in terms of food. That process is said to be food chain. Right? Now, the plants are the only one that who produce their own food. Human beings cannot produce their own food.
Human beings can produce their own food.
Actually, human beings can produce their food with the help of plants only. They need to grow some crops, they need to grow some plants. right? But the plants are the one that they are prepare their food on their own.
Okay.
They don't need help of any other living organism for that. But living organisms like human beings and animals are dependent on the plant. So the plants are the first stage of any chain. In food consumption terms, plants are the first member of any chain. Okay? You are aware of the process photosynthesis?
Photosynthesis where the process how plants produce their like sunlight produces plants and stuff.
Photosynthesis is a process of production of food in plants.
Yeah.
So what basically the photosynthesis is, they plants use to prepare the food of their own using the sunlight and water. And using that, they produce some glucose. Glucose is basically starch that is produced by plants, and this is utilized by other living organisms.
Okay.
Okay. So, the process in which this food is produced is photosynthesis, and then there is some respiration processes also in the plants. That process is your transpiration. So we'll take up this topic, transpiration, also in detail, how the plants breathe in, breathe out, different parts of the plants, the roots, the stem, the leaves, how, which part is doing what kind of work. That all will be discussed in this thing. Okay?
Okay.
Next thing we study about is about the flowers. What are flowers? What are the leaves of the flower known to be? They are known to be petals.
Yeah.
What is the role of the petals in the flowers? That all thing we will study.
Okay.
After the plants, we will be moving towards the human body.
Okay.
Human body consists of so many complex processes. The first is the structure of the human body. The human body is made up of so many bones.
Yes.
Fleshy skins, bones. So bones provide a basic structure to the human body.
Mm-hmm.
Every part of human body is having bone in it. Either soft bone or hard bone, but every part is having a bone in it. So bones are the basic thing which provide a structure to the human body, particularly a shape to the human body. So every bones are having some joints in them. Like this is my elbow. This is having a joint. Knees are having a joint. Okay?
Yeah.
These joints should be flexible in the movement so that our body parts can move. So after the plants, we will study about human beings. And after the human beings' body movement and all, we will come up to the animals. Now, in animals, we are going to study about their habitat. What is habitat?
Habitat is where you live, like where they made their home and like where they generated their family and stuff.
So habitat is basically an environment in which the animals used to live.
Yeah.
So there are different kinds of habitat. Like for sea animals, the habitat is different. For desert animals, it is different. Mm-hmm. For forest animals, it is different. Everyone is having different habitat, and according to their body characteristic, they choose their habitat. Like an example for fish. Fish can live only in water, so it chooses its habitat as a sea.
Okay.
Turtle can live both in water and in the surface.
Yeah.
So its habitat is different. Like I give you an example of camel. What kind of habitat a camel is having?
Desert,
because it can live in that. Its skin type is that kind of that it can store the tons of water in it. So it don't need water on the daily basis.
Yeah.
Right, so their skin type is according to their skin type, their body structure, and their requirement for the foods and the water and other other things, they choose their habitat and environment to live in.
Okay.
So this is a short introduction of bio of sixth standard, what basically in this complete year you are going to study. These were the short terms. When we take them one by one, we are going to have a lot of detailing in them.
Okay.
Okay. Now I am coming up to physics. What is physics?
Physics is like the movement of air and like how you move.
Sorry, I didn't get you.
Physics is like the movement of objects and stuff. And like how much pressure you put on stuff.
So basically, physics is that branch of science that deals with the structure of the matters, movement of the matters, right? So what we basically do is study in it is motion, movement. What is motion?
Motion is like how you move, like what movement you're doing, like what action you're doing, like that's motion.
So motion can be of different type, like your circular motion, your rectilinear motion. Have you listened to these terms before?
No.
Just a short introduction. Circular motion is when somebody is moving in circular form. That motion is circular motion. Rectilinear motion, when we are moving over a straight line.
Okay.
That motion is said to be rectilinear motion.
Okay.
Okay. So different kinds of motion we are going to study in this. Next thing we are going to study is about the units. Before the units, let's talk about distance and displacement. What are they?
Distance is like how far something is, and I think displacement is when the distance is not correct.
No, distance is something like I am moving from point A, go to point B, C, then D, then E, like this. So my total distance will be A to B to C to D to E. That will be my total distance. Displacement is something which is in a straight line, like A to B. This is my displacement.
Okay.
Okay. Now, when we talk about some measurements of the distances, we have to talk about the SI units. SI units are my standard international units, like kilometer,
Oh.
meter, centimeter, millimeter. These all are what? These are my SI units in which we measure the distances. Like if I ask you to measure the length of a table. You know what is length and breadth and height?
Yeah.
If this is a cube, then this thing is my length. This thing vertical is my height. And the depth kind of thing is said to be breadth.
Yeah.
So if I ask you to measure the length of any table, that you will measure in centimeters.
Yeah.
So what I'll say, the SI unit for the measurement of table is centimeter.
Okay.
And what we are basically measuring, we are measuring the distance between two points of a table from starting edge to the ending edge.
Okay.
So, distance we are measuring between two points. Okay?
Okay.
This is about the measurement. Next thing we are going to study in physics is light, shadows, and reflection. What is light, shadow, and reflection? Tell me one by one what you know about them.
Light is what comes from like electricity or the sun. Shadows are what light makes and reflects on your body that shows shadows. And reflection is basically the thing that bounces off something.
Let's start with the light. Light is something that is very much required to see for visibility.
Okay.
If we need the visibility of anything, we require light. In dark, we cannot see anything.
No.
So for visibility, light is the most important thing. Now, light can be natural light. Natural light, that is the light of the sun and the moon. It can be artificial light. Artificial light that we produce by electricity. That is the light from the bulb, from some tube light, from some lampshade like that.
Yeah.
So light is the essential requirement for anything. Now in the light, we have, for the traveling of light, we have different kinds of medium. Translucent, and opaque. What are they?
Transparent is something that is see-through. Translucent is something that is maybe something that is see-through but only can go a certain distance.
And opaque?
Opaque. I think opaque is not transparent.
Yes. Transparent is something that allow all the light to pass through it so that one can see clearly from the both sides.
Okay. Yeah.
Your example for transparent is, tell me,
something that is see-through.
Example, some object which is transparent.
Glass.
Glass is transparent in nature. We can see in the both sides through it.
Yeah.
Translucent is something that allow partial light to pass through it. Means you, there is some visibility to the other side, but not completely.
Okay.
Like your butter paper.
Yeah.
Butter paper is translucent in nature. You can see to the other side, but that is not clear. Vision is not clear.
Okay.
And opaque is something that do not allow any kind of light to pass through it. That is completely dark. Example, your wood.
Yeah.
If you are placing a wooden object between you and your view, then your view is completely blocked.
Yeah.
So these are the three types of objects we deal with when we are talking about light. Transparent, translucent, and opaque.
Okay.
Then comes the shadows. Shadows are something that are, they have some minimal requirement to be produced. First, for the production of shadow, light is a must thing. Mm-hmm. In a dark, you cannot have a shadow.
No.
There must be some light medium over there.
Yeah.
Secondly, shadow is always of some opaque material only.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot have a shadow of a transparent or translucent material.
No.
Only an opaque material can have a shadow. And the third requirement for shadow is that some flat surface should be there on which the shadow can be formed.
Yeah.
If there is no flat surface, you cannot see shadow anywhere. It cannot be seen in midway in the air or something. You cannot see the shadow on in sky.
No.
You need a perfect ground or some background on which a shadow can be formed.
Yeah.
Like take an example of a projector. What projector is doing? Projector is projecting the light of something over the screen. Without the screen, there is no use of projector.
No.
That is the reason behind the formation of shadow. The shadow needs a perfect background. So that the light it is getting concentrated, that light should be fall on some object so that it will get rearranged into something.
Okay.
Also, the another characteristic of shadow, it is always dark in nature. You cannot give the perfect figure. It's just you get the boundary of something. You cannot, like if there is a shadow of human being, you cannot see the nose, eyes, ears, mouth separately. No. You will just have a boundary shape figure of the human body.
Yeah.
Right? You cannot see colors in it.
No.
It means if two humans of same height and same body structure are standing together, then their shadows will be same. You cannot identify whose shadow is whose.
Yeah.
So this is what the shadow is. This is basically the difference between a shadow and an image. Image is what? Image is a perfect image of a person that we used to take with a camera. You can identify the thing.
Yeah.
Like in my example, if two person are standing together of same height and size, if you click an image of that of both of them, you can easily identify them.
Yeah.
And also the image is having color in it. Complete characteristics can be shown and complete colors can be shown through an image. So this is the difference between a shadow and an image.
Okay.
Next comes the reflection. Reflection is something that is reflecting the light which is falling over it. For example, the mirror.
Yeah.
Mirror reflects back all the light that is falling on it. That is why when we are standing in front of the mirror, the light from our body is going towards the mirror, then mirror reflects back all the light to us again and we can see ourselves in the mirror.
Mm-hmm.
Now the mirror can identify the colors. The perfect characteristic can be seen through mirrors.
Yeah, you can see it.
Only the one thing that is different in mirror is that left become right and right become left.